In this video, I will share with you how to buy NFT with MetaMask. And MetaMask is probably one of the most popular wallets when it comes to NFT. However, keep in mind that MetaMask is an online wallet and it's not an offline hardware wallet such as the Ledger. For example, I prefer to keep my long-term investments on the Ledger offline, so it's more secured and my crypto stays away from the hackers. However, there is never ever a guarantee in the crypto field or on the NFT world, so keep that in mind before you risk a single dollar. Now, there are many different ways to buy NFTs from the marketplace. Some platforms offer the possibility to buy straight away with your Visa card, which is super comfortable, but MetaMask is the wallet that became kind of trusty and everyone uses it. This is why it is available on most platforms. So if you want to buy NFT from one platform, you can buy it using MetaMask, and if you want to sell it on another platform, you can transfer the NFT via your MetaMask wallet. It is attached to the browser, it is super easy to use, and in this video I will show you how to buy NFT with MetaMask. If you're ready, let's get to work. So if you haven't installed MetaMask on your browser, you need to visit the official website and always download the wallets from the official website, okay? So in this case, you need to visit metamask.io and download it. It is a few simple steps that you need to follow. I'm not going to make the video boring and show all the steps because it is super easy to follow. Just very importantly, when you see the recovery phrase, you need to write that on a piece of paper and store it somewhere offline. As I said, a piece of paper works best in case you need to recover your wallet, because in this MetaMask wallet you will be actually keeping some Ethereum in most of the cases, so when you want to buy NFTs from OpenSea or any other platform, so make sure to keep it safe somewhere in your house or safe wherever you feel comfortable storing that piece of paper. And once you're ready with installation, it is time to fund the wallet. And if you're doing it for a very, very first time, I would suggest you to fund with a small amount of Ethereum. It could be just something like $100 or $200. So you can test it out, buy some cheap NFTs and see how the whole process works before you purchase some more expensive NFTs with your MetaMask wallet. And I already recorded a video about how to fund MetaMask wallet. It will appear right in that corner. You can check it out so you can see some tips from me on how to fund cheaper the MetaMask wallet. Now, after you're ready, I will tell you how to buy NFT with MetaMask wallet on any platform, but for the purpose of that video, I'll be using OpenSea. So the first thing you have to do is to connect the wallet. I will tap on that icon that looks exactly like a wallet, and you can see that it's not just MetaMask, it is Wallet Connect, Coinbase Wallet, Automatic, but as I said, MetaMask is the most popular one until the moment, and I will just click on it and I will need to paste my password. I like that Foxy with the moving head, it just moves wherever you move the mouse. So right now I will just paste the password and I will click on unlock. Let me translate it to English. It says unlocking. I will tap on that and it was unlocked. You can see that in this MetaMask wallet I have about $145, which is approximately 0.0380 of Ethereum, and now I am good to go. I can purchase NFTs on OpenSea. Now you can go straight away to the marketplace and choose any NFTs. Of course, there are some expensive ones, there are cheap ones. Starting from 0.03 or 0.02 even, you can find some cheap ones. And at the same time, if you click on rankings, you will see that there are some expensive ones. For example, the CryptoPunks are super popular, as well the Bored Ape Yacht Club, which I have shown a few times. You can see floor price of 35 Ethereums. I really like those monkeys. But one more time, if you're doing it for a first time, I would suggest you to stick to some of the cheap ones. And now I will show you how to buy NFT with a MetaMask wallet. So I will go to the marketplace and I will select on any of the cheap ones. You can see one at a price of 0.0006, which is quite cheap. I will just click on it randomly and I can select buy now. Okay, now this is the Neon District Season 1 team. I have no idea about the team. I'm not promoting them in this video. I just picked this NFT super randomly and the price is about $2.50. So why not, right? But let me show you something. If I agree to the terms and conditions and I click on confirm checkout, I will have to sign the MetaMask again. Let me translate it one more time in English. Not sure why it's keep translating on Bulgarian. Now I will click on signature. You will see the message that this NFT is actually on the Polygon blockchain and I need to deposit Ethereum to the Polygon blockchain, which is preferable platform for the cheap NFTs because there we don't pay gas fees. Okay, so pay attention to that. If you want to buy some cheap NFTs on the Polygon, you need to transfer some Ethereum. Now I won't be doing that, but I will select another NFT that is on the Ethereum blockchain. By the way, you can see that we have the Polygon icon on some of the NFTs and on others we don't have it, right? So this way you can notice when we are on the Polygon blockchain and when we are on the Ethereum blockchain. Okay, so really randomly I will pick any NFT, this one, but I have no idea what that is. Okay, but I will click on it and I will just click on buy now and I will agree to the terms and conditions. I will confirm the checkout again and here you will see the gas fee. Okay, this is what I wanted to show you. Estimated gas fee about $46 and it will change in approximately 30 seconds. Here we go, 44. So keep in mind that there are gas fees on the Ethereum blockchain. And personally for me, when I'm going for a cheap NFT, it's not worth it to spend $50 on a gas fee if the NFT is about 100 or 150, which means that I'll be spending like 30% for gas fee extra for the price I'm about to pay on OpenSea or any other platform for the NFT itself. So this is why I said if you're going for cheap NFTs, you better look at the Polygon blockchain where we don't pay gas fees. But if you are purchasing NFTs on the Ethereum blockchain, you will pay gas fees, okay? Personally, I don't find that reasonable to spend more than 10% for gas fees, which means that if I buy NFTs for $500, I don't wanna spend more than $50, okay? But cheaper NFTs and spending more than $50 just doesn't make sense, right? So definitely I will cancel that and I will go back to the marketplace to look for different NFTs. But I just wanted to show you how to buy NFT with MetaMask. It's super easy. Once attached to the browser, you need to fund it and then you can browse through the marketplace. One more time, I will repeat, if you go for cheap ones, look at the Polygon blockchain because there are no gas fees. If you are looking for NFTs that are above $500, for example, it is okay to spend $30, $40, $50 for gas fee, but not more, okay? I always try to spend less than 10% for gas fees. And one last thing in the end, if you buy NFTs with MetaMask on OpenSea, those NFTs will be actually stored on the MetaMask wallet itself, which means that you can transfer these NFTs to other NFT marketplaces such as Rarible, CryptoKitties. You can move the NFTs to any platform where MetaMask is accepted. And I know that many of you right now could be worried about this Ethereum gas fees and why we're spending that much money on nothing. Well, this is how it works, and I have recorded a video especially about explaining how the gas fees work. So I'll drop it right in here. Have a look at it if you're not familiar with the gas fees on OpenSea, and don't hesitate to ask me any questions in the comments below. All right, guys, so this is how to buy NFT with MetaMask wallet. It's super easy. If you have no idea from where to buy Ethereum or any other crypto, check out the links below in the description. I have listed some of the trustiest exchanges, and as well from there you can grab some free Bitcoin after you make your first investment. Now keep in mind that the NFT market is full of surprises. There is nothing guaranteed. It is absolutely free to upload any kind of artwork. Some people make money, others lose, but it is extremely interesting to participate on the NFT market. I love it, it's super exciting, and I will see you guys with more video about the NFTs. You take care, and I will see you soon. Oh, I always forget that. Like and subscribe to the channel.